Hey everyone, welcome back to another Watch Me Work style video. Today we are gonna do these fabulous wine nails on my mom. So this tutorial was pre-filmed back before the move, still playing catch up on my videos, but she wanted some wine nails. So let me show you what we did. So if this is your first time watching my Watch Me Work style videos, what they are is they are a combination of the traditional tutorial, but they're also you guys getting a little bit of interaction between me and my client. So my mom and I have a lot of fun together whenever I work on her nails.
You ready, mom?
I'm ready.
So these lasted well for you?
They did.
And what are we doing on your nails today, mom?
Vino.
I was like, what's vino? We should be drinking vino. I haven't really been into vino lately though.
Yeah, that's what I noticed from your vlogs.
Well, I pour it and then I don't drink it all. It's like I forget that it's even there. Just relax.
I'm sorry, how about I relax?
Stop trying to help me.
So my first step on her nails is to remove her Swarovski crystals. I usually use a combination of cuticle nippers, nail clippers, and toenail clippers to remove crystals.
I probably won't go with them, but you can let me know.
Yeah, I'll give you my ideas so you can completely ignore them. Oh, what idea was that, T, that you liked of mine?
The red, white, and rosé. I have a vision for it. I just can't narrow down my color choices yet. Ah, sorry. I need to go get that plate though. Maybe that'll help me. Clear jelly stamper, new plates, a wine plate, and then a small, ooh, I like the packaging on that, the back of it. You know what else? I have to grab something else that's wine. Hang on. Vino decals.
See, you'd have to use.
Don't tell me what I have to do.
Oh, I don't know why I'm trying.
Yeah, so I'm gonna do, the three that I'm gonna do is decals, stamp, and then the 3D glass. But we could do four, and we could do a cameo, because you could put one of these decals, maybe that's what we'll do, the decal in the cameo.
Ooh.
Hey, that'll be fun.
Like a glass or a vino bottle?
I think a vino bottle, because, well, how much shorter do you want your nails?
Just a little bit, not much.
Yeah, then we can easily fit a vino bottle, I think. No?
Well, are you gonna use the cameo rings?
Yeah.
And the vino bottle will fit in the cameo ring?
If I can find it. Shoot, what if I packed them up? I think I spent like, what, half an hour looking here? 15 minutes?
15 minutes, maybe 10.
Ugh. Okay, so back to the drawing board.
So what have you decided?
So, okay, do you want two 3D wine glasses? Like one with white wine, one with red wine, and then we'll stamp this in like a rosé? I seriously can't figure out what background to do with the wine glasses though. I know you had a weird idea, but I'm not sure if I like it. Okay, whatever. We'll just start and see what happens.
Okay.
Okay. Vanilla bean. This is one I was thinking. And velvet hammer. I like these two together. And then if I wet marble them, I think it'll look kind of like this.
Okay, I'll leave it up to you.
Okay.
So I decided that I wanted the background of the nails to be like a wet marbled type of look using these light neutral colors. So I'm taking some of Light Elegance's Vanilla Bean and Velvet Hammer, and I'm just randomly placing them on the nails. The brush that I'm using here is my Light Elegance Oval No. 4 brush. It's my favorite color gel brush. After I have the product where I want it, I'm gonna go in with Ugly Duckling's Omni Tool just around the cuticles, adding some more color. Once I have all of the color all over the nails where I want it, I'm going to go in with my brush again and I'm just going to lightly drag all of these colors together. So because Velvet Hammer has kind of a see-through effect going on, it's causing the Vanilla Bean, which is a little bit more pigmented, to blend together and give it this really cool transparent translucent look. I love marbling like this and especially with these type of colors.
We have three different kinds of wine. So I'm not sure how to organize this. Like white and rosé on this hand. We'll do two whites because I like white. Right?
Sure, it's all about you. Okay.
So if we're doing white and rosé, then I want this to be a red glitter nail. Like a Merlot, Merlot type of glitter.
Yeah.
And then this one could either match it or it could be purple or whatever to match the grapes. And then it'll be the opposite on this hand, whatever we decide to do. So this one will have red and white, so then I have to do like a rosé glitter to match. And then this one we'll use the rosé glitter on, which we can just leave it at that. We don't have to throw any green or anything in.
Okay.
You wanna do that?
Sure.
No green glitter?
No green glitter.
Okay. That's pretty. I actually don't even know if I've ever used that color. That's a good wine mix. Hey?
Well, you got, yeah, you've got your white rosé and your beautiful Cab Sav or Merlot.
That's a good wine color. No?
I think we're putting that on every finger.
You're not getting that on every finger.
I promise I'm nice to my mom, you guys. These videos probably show that I'm not, but I love that my mom tries to help me with designs, and I really appreciate her input and listening to me toss around ideas, but ultimately, I usually decide what I want to do. So I'm just taking this beautiful Merlot color, and this is from Light Elegance. This is actually called Pour Me a Kiss. It's the perfect color for wine nails, and I'm applying it to her pinky. Now, you guys got a little bit of the behind the scenes of my thought process when it comes to like a really creative set like this. So because on the other nails, like I said, I'm going to do a white and a rosé accent nail, I wanted the color on the pinkies to be different but still tying everything together. I'm big on tying all the colors together. So on this pinky, I'm using my Accents Rose Gold Leaf, which was a perfect rosé type of shade for this design. So continuing the opposite train, because I did the Merlot type of shade on my mom's right hand on her pinky, I'm going to do the opposite color by using the rose gold accent leaf on that thumb, and then vice versa on the other hand. So we're going to jump a little bit ahead here, and I have encapsulated all of the color gels. We have finished filed, and now we're going to move on to the stamping and Swarovski crystals. So on these two nails, I didn't need to fill in the wine glasses. I just wanted the outline for the stamping because I'm going to fill them in later with something else.
There's not technically an actual white wine glass though.
Which one looks better as wine?
I would rather use this because it's not metallic, and then this will be your metallic labels.
Have you got a darker one than this?
It's packed.
Oh!
But it's not clear jelly, so...
Oh, well then we weren't going to use it anyways.
No.
So on this pointer finger, I wanted a red wine bottle. Make sure when you're stamping these that you're watching that the corks are lining up properly and that the labels are lining up properly, because I struggled with this particular stamp quite a bit. You need to make sure it's all lined up so the outline lines up.
I really want to do one of these, but I want to make this nail shiny and this matched so it looks like a chalkboard.
Is that where you're putting vinyl?
Yeah.
To achieve this effect, I want to first top gloss this nail with my Ugly Duckling No Wipe Top Gloss. Taking some of my black stamping polish, I'm going to pull it in this image. So I know that a lot of you guys struggle with these kind of bigger images. I just want to suggest that you use quite a bit of polish and make sure you are using your flick of the wrist type of motion there. I'm going to outline this with my white stamping polish, and then I'm going to use a gold stamping polish. All these polishes are from Clear Jelly Stamper to do the words. Now, I'm not paying much attention to the excess polish that's getting on her finger because I am going to go in with some nail polish remover on a Q-tip and remove any excess on the nail that I don't want. I'm just going to finish up this design by taking some of my Ugly Duckling Matte Top Gloss and just carefully going in the black where the chalkboard is. This is going to seal the black stamping polish in, but it's also going to give that a chalkboard matte type of finish. I love the contrast between shiny and matte, especially on one nail in particular. So on my mom's middle fingers, I wanted to make these glasses look like they were a little bit raised. So I'm taking some of Accents Rose Gold Leaf on this particular nail so that when I apply the clear gel will look a lot bigger, I guess. It'll make sense soon, I promise. And then on her other middle finger, I'm taking some of Accents Gold Leaf and doing the exact same effect. So you want to take a really thick gel here. I'm pretty sure I'm using my Fusion 5. And you want to just kind of blob it on, but making sure to make the center of it where that bubble is be the biggest point of the nail. If you're finding that this gel is like not working for you, just tilt your client's hand upside down and that'll cause the gel to kind of pool more and make it look more like a raised glass. I also ended up adding a second coat of this for this rosé type of nail because it wasn't as raised as I had wanted it to be. So that's another option for you too if you want it to look a little bit more raised. I also decided to take my brush down the stem of the nail as well as the base. That way it looks like a solid glass, but keep in mind that you want the majority of the product to be in the belly of the glass. So on my mom's ring fingers, we want to cover the wine, I guess you would say, in Swarovski crystals to give it kind of an interesting effect. So I'm using that exact same Pour Me a Kiss color for her red wine glass, and then on her other finger, I'm going to use the Accents Gold to fill in the glass. After you've cured that, make sure you remove the dispersion layer and then go in with some of your favorite Swarovski crystal glue. As usual, I'm using my Light Elegance Nail Glue, my Ugly Duckling Blinger Tool, and these micro swabs that I get off of eBay. The Swarovski crystal color that I'm using for the white is a combination of a bunch of different colors, actually. But mostly I'm using Light Colorado Topaz, I believe. I found this to match pretty well. For the red wine, the shot was completely out of focus, you guys, so I apologize for that. But the crystal color that I used for the red wine is Siam.
It's kind of funny, like these crystals, they're like a peach color, right? But because we're pairing it to make it look like rosé, you think of them as more rose.
Yeah, don't get carried away. I can't hold as many crystals on my other finger, I've been told.
On your dinky pinky?
On my slimmer
nail, your on the slimmer other hand. Nail. That was funny. Did you see Ivory's comment on that? She was like, she commented, dinky pinky, bah ha ha ha. I burst out laughing when you said that.
If you guys don't know what we're talking about, you'll have to go back and watch the Nativity nails. So on this nail, I'm using a combination of the Light Colorado Topaz as well as the Swarovski crystal called Rose Peach.
I can't even think straight. I'm so tired. That just exhausted me. I do want red crystals. I'm not even done with crystals. Let's just move this out of the way.
What are we doing?
I don't know. I can't. I'm so tired. It was like I fell asleep in there or
something.
That's
what I'm saying. Once you get that comfortable, it's kind of hard to...
I didn't fall asleep in there, but...
My mom and I were doing her nails really late, and my daughter was having a really difficult time going to sleep, so I ended up going up to take care of her about 3 or 4 times, and I was, like, exhausted by the time I came down to finish this set on my mom.
I was thinking about that while I was in the chair up there. I was like, do I want to do them angled or straight? And I always suck at doing them straight, so that's why everything goes on angles.
So on her thumbnails, we decided to use some of the word prints that were on the stamping plate and then just combine it with some Swarovski crystals. Whenever I stamp, I don't overly pay attention to the excess polish that goes on the nail because I know I can easily remove it.
Mom, I think you're going to have to finish your own nails tonight.
I was sitting down here thinking, I have no idea what to do next.
You know the steps. You've gotten your nails done enough, no?
No. All I remember is when that birdie one comes on, that's all.
You know what I'd really like? An assistant.
Oh, she'd just get in your way.
You think so? I think that you just have to, like, learn to clone yourself. Because as long as my assistant was like me,
oh, good God,
it'd be perfect.
Like
thanks. But you're doing...
What do you think? Well, she tells you to say no.
Do you like that nail or no? Do you hate it?
Well, that's cool.
Okay,
no,
good.
I like
Thank
that.
Goodness. Because I'm not fixing it.
I'm sorry. Is that what you meant to say?
Do thumbs or crystals on your thumb bug you?
Yeah, only when I'm trying to tie shoelaces.
Why? When do you tie shoelaces?
I don't anymore.
I know. Didn't you mention that in my last video too?
I did.
Why did you mention in my last video? What were we talking
about?
Well,
you were putting it on the first two nails. And I'm like, oh, that doesn't work.
Oh my gosh. My mom and I just have way too much fun together when I do her nails. So I'm just going to finish up on her thumb here with applying a bunch of the Light Colorado Topaz Swarovski crystals. You guys know that I like to tie the colors of the design together here. So I have my Merlot type of base and I have gold on top of it. Then we're going to move on to her pinky, and we're just going to bling this out as well with some of the Siam and again the Light Colorado Topaz Swarovski crystals. Now the sizes here, in the middle here it's an SS16, I want to say. The next size down is an SS9, and then the small ones are SS5s. I was just winging it at this point though, you guys. I was so tired and I was just so concerned about my little girl too. I had no idea what was going on. I still to this day have not figured out what was going on, but with toddlers, it could really just be anything. So after the crystals are done, it's time to apply our top gloss. You just want to make sure when you're going around the ones that are raised that you're not putting the top gloss over top of the gel because it'll just make it kind of look bulky. You do want to keep that separation there. Now on her pinky, I did notice that it was a little bit shadowy, so I'm just going in with a second coat of that Pour Me a Kiss color. When you're top glossing nails with Swarovski crystal, you never want to put top gloss on top of the Swarovski crystals because it will dull them. Instead, take a really fine brush, So after I've applied my lotion, what I'm doing here is just going in with some of my LCN Super Shine Finish Cleaner on the shiny nails. On the matte nails, I like to take some of my CanWest post-service wipe just to make that matte kind of pop a little bit more. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch me put a whole bunch of wine and wine accessories on my mom's nails. When I saw a clear jelly stamper come out with a wine plate, I was so excited to put a whole bunch of wine accessories on my mom's nails. I thought that she would be the perfect candidate for this design. Make sure you're following me on all of my social media. Thank you guys again, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!